Tonight's show is called Singing a Story About Love. And this is a really unique show. I know you guys have been kindergarten and first grade shows. There's a lot of music and a lot of songs that have already been written for and be used. This is a unique show in that the students are learning about weather in their classrooms. And although there are a lot of songs about weather, there's not a lot of songs about specific concepts of weather. So the uniqueness of this show is that the students actually created, each class creates their own song and wrote their own song based on a property of weather that they've actually been studying. So I think it's a very exciting show. You're probably going to learn something tonight. It's really neat to hear the songs that they've actually written. So I think you'll be impressed. Classes for tonight, this is Scheidler, this is Banks, this is Musselman, this is Malco, this is Worthy, this is Sewell, and this is Ramsey. And I also want to mention this is Wall, who is a student teacher for us, and she's also going to be our narrator tonight, and she is going to be a part of the show as well. Special thanks to, obviously, all the second grade teachers. Putting a show like this together really requires a lot of coordination, a lot of flexibility in the schedule, and allowing the whole second grade to get together and rehearse becomes a challenge. So we appreciate the second grade teachers in doing that. The IAs, our custodians, Lulu, and our office staff, and the rest of the Columbia family. I'd like to thank Mr. Bernacki, Mr. Lawson, and Mr. and Mrs. Bollinger for their help as well. A lot of people came together to help with this concert together. We will be having an ice cream social afterwards. It will be directly behind you. This is PTO ice cream social that we have. It's $1 per serving. And PTO, if you're not very familiar with it, all of the proceeds go back to our students or our building in some way and helps us out a lot. So at the end of the concert, the students and Mrs. Worley, Mrs. Musselman, Mrs. Ramsey will meet your parents. They will be in the library, so you can go to library doors over there. Students and Mrs. Banks and Mrs. Worley will be in the conference room beside the library, which is back in this corner of the building. The doors on the right, it's out the very end of the hall. And the students and Ms. Sewell and Mrs. Malco's class, they'll be in the choir room, which is directly behind you. And you guys will want to pick them up and have to release the kids out into the halls because it's chaotic. So, I will dismiss you from the auditorium as soon as we get everybody off of the stage. That way they're in safe in their locations. Take the videos and pictures. You are more than welcome to do so tonight. We just ask that you keep that for your personal use. Even though the songs are written in kind of our property, the music itself is not, and so we have to abide by the copyright law. And I'd like to thank RTC for coming in and videotaping tonight. They make these videos available for you, and you can purchase them online at the RTC website. And give a couple weeks, and they'll be up there, and you can buy a professional version. I do not want to take up any more of your time. You guys are in for a very special show tonight. These kids, I can hear them back here getting ready. They've put a lot of time and effort into this. You will be able to tell because they do a fantastic job. And lastly, I just want to thank Jill Weaver. Jill Weaver does a fabulous job with these kids. She puts a lot of time and energy into it. It truly is in her heart to teach these kids music, the theory of music, and how to perform. She does a great job. I'm just super impressed with how she's able to put these things together. So, without further ado, I will kick off. So, hope you enjoy your evening.
Yeah, Keeps trying. Thank you. Why did the weather ask for privacy?
It wanted to change.
Because of the whole side of the equator.
You're hot
stuff.
Why did the wind finish the test before everyone else?
You got away from me.
What falls before it?
Never gets hurt.
We call that fog. If nimbus is part of the cloud name, that means that the cloud carries
to know what to do when a storm is coming. If you listen to the experts, often you have enough time to get prepared. Our next song was written to the tune of Alabama Gal. Storms Are Coming, written by Mrs. Sewell's class, will tell you how to be prepared for the next storm that comes our way.
To another one of our favorite songs, She'll Be Coming Around the Mountain. Thank you.